Well, you really didn't. What's done is done. It kind of got so glum in here. Perhaps you, Stepan, could play us something.
Sure thing.
Artyom, the colonel's waiting for you on the bridge.
So that is why I say we should wait. He came back from that library. And this is nothing. We will pick him up on our way back.
If we live to go back.
Oh, come on!
Well, I just think we should still drink to Duke's memory. And if he's alive, that's only a good omen. Sam, what do you say?
I'll drink later. Gotta finish cooking.
Okay.
Let's drink!
All right, let's! It's rough.
Yeah, kinda rough.
By the way, speaking of omens, let's have a service for him once we come across another church.
Duke didn't believe, and having met Salantius, I'm also wavering.
Well, Salantius' god is definitely a lost cause. But I imagine Duke would like Valhalla, a paradise where fallen heroes spend eternity feasting and fighting, a good fit for all of the people we lost.
Yes, this is worth having another drink for. To our guys having fun in Valhalla! Hey guys, there's something I've been thinking about. What does everyone expect of this trip? Duke used to say that he just couldn't spread his wings back home. He was too eager to win that girl over with heroics. He thought that outside he'd have space for that.
And why did you come?
Well, my heart is aching for true romance. But in the Metro, all women want a solid relationship, a reliable husband, a real provider. Enough of that smug smile. It's unbearable. Not that I've had much better luck here so far. As soon as Katia came aboard, Stepan started cooing around her like a peacock.
You should be happy. Katia's a tough girl. You'd be under her thumb in no time.
That is unlikely. I'm not the kind of man to upstage his friend in a contest for a lady. Especially when that friend promises to break my arm!
Thank you.
Listen. I had a talk with the Ark. All thanks to Tokarev. He got the decoder working.
Ark, come in. Come in, Ark. Over. This is Ark. Identify yourself. Over. This is Colonel Svetoslav Myonnikov speaking. I'm in command of a special operations force. We have received your signal and are currently heading your way. Do you copy? Over.
Yes, yes. Hear you loud and clear.
Who am I talking to? How do I address you?
The Deputy Chief of the Communications Department, Major Ivanov. A moment.
Oh, yes, Major. I understand that the checkup is in order.
Great, Colonel. Melnikov? Simply capable. I am sorry for the lack of trust, but as you know, the enemy is always ready to strike.
I do understand, Major, and I hope that you will tell the leadership that my people are true to their duty and will be at their full disposal as soon as we arrive.
Thank you for the great news. How large is your force, Colonel?
I have a squad of defense operatives that the special forces have to offer.
That's good. Thank you.
Artyom, that should be enough, huh? Just like back in preschool, eh, Artyom? Instead of wasting steam, I'd rather you go down and stoke that fire, huh?
I'm so excited, my hands are still shaking.
The minister himself! This is incredible!
By the way, Artyom, you should take a look at the map. Thank you.
So, we can hope for smooth sailing from here, and right to the very destination. It's not even that far, but our speed depends on the state of the truck. So, I think it's going to take us quite some time to get there.
We are approaching the Yamantau bunker, the final destination of our long journey. Direct radio contact with the bunker has completely dissolved Miller's resentment towards me for destroying our previous lives. He is eagerly anticipating the meeting with the Minister of Defense he was promised. Probably such things are important for a career officer. The people, though, are less interested. They are asking important questions. Where are the occupying forces? Why is there just wilderness and people gone wild around? What's stopping the government from restoring the country? What was being done in the last 20 years? Miller believes that we'll get all the answers. He will be pardoned, as well as Anna and I. And we will all return home to the metro.
What's going on ahead? Over.
Everything's abandoned, but the truck is okay. Over.
Roger that. Don't go too fast, and watch out for radiation. Over.
Roger that.
I still can't believe this. We're there. You get this. We're finally there. This has been our goal, not for weeks or months, but for 20 years. My whole life, and it was not spent in vain. Now I know it for a fact.
Mama, look, are we going to live here now?
I don't know. Why?
I don't like this place. It's creepy.
Shh, don't say that.
Over, Carol. It's getting really hot out here.
Everyone, masks on. Passengers, get inside and button up tight.
Yes, of course. Come on, Nastya.
Change of plans. We're taking the rail car from here. Wait for Artyom and me.
Roger that.
How about me? You've been dreaming to get here for so long, and are now leaving me behind? Am I your daughter or not?
All right, come with us, or else I'll never hear the end of it.
A wise decision.
Yermak, stop the engine. Back to the safe zone and sit tight there.
We do that right now.
Stepan, you're in charge while I'm away.
Sir, yes, sir.
Great. Let's go. This place. Worse than Moscow.
Yeah, looks like it.
See that crater? Wonder what the yield was on that one. Looks like 100 to me. Your guys have got 3,500 guns too. Well, even 100 seems to have done okay.
Look at all those cars. Artyom was right. People were coming here from all over the country.
Yes, they were. Nobody came from Moscow. Until now.
So much time wasted.
We'll make up for that now. Well, we're almost there.
Oh, no, we're not there. Look, this is a bad place. Now we shouldn't have come. Really?
Okay, so where's my welcoming committee and red carpet? I don't get this.
Oh, see? Nobody home. How about we go back, huh? Bye.
Look!
Identify yourself.
Colonel Miller, here to report to the Minister of Defense.
And where are your people, Colonel?
With the train.
It's dangerous outside. Contact them and tell them to take the train into the main airlock for decontamination. Welcome to the Ark, Colonel. Proceed through the tunnel and take the elevator. You'll be met inside.
Is what's spooky here. Well, if push comes to shove, you'll have to pretend to be a mute hero.
Look, Sam, the locks here are just like in D6. I can open them with a nail.
The whole thing looks a lot like D6. No imagination.
Did you at least prepare a speech? Reporting to the minister is no joke.
Ah, get off my case. I pulled an all-nighter.
Don't you feel like you should say something to Artyom now?
Yes. You were right, Artyom. And I was wrong. Thanks for not giving up. Nothing! Comrade Minister! Commander of the Joint Special Operations Forces Squadron of the City of Moscow, Colonel Miller, reporting. I would like to request that my people are provided with temporary quarters and supplies, as there are women and children among us. Still, our fighters are in top shape and ready for action.
Women and children? Good. Haven't had those in a while.
Who are you?
Everything is going as planned. Everyone is fine. So far.
So far? I demand a meeting with the Minister of Defense now!
Do not worry. Everything will be just fine. And even better. The Minister and the Chief himself are expecting you for dinner.
Dinner? What the hell? Are you fucking mocking me?
Shut up! The doctor is talking.
Where is the government? Answer!
All here, Colonel. All here. We are the government you people deserve.
Don't you dare, you fuck! You're just fucking cannibals!
Calm down, you'll get jaundice like this. And believe me, nobody likes that bitter taste. The girl will have to wait, though. We must run the tests first. I don't like that cough
of
hers.
I'll tie my hands, you motherfucker! And I'll shove those tests so far up your ass, you'll be spitting
them! Watch your tone, young lady. Do as that young man does. He woke up long ago, but quietly listens to wise people talk.
You fucker! Let me go!
Not a single!
So, Colonel, now you will pick up the radio and tell the rest of your people on the train to come here. If you don't want her to suffer for a really long time before she is served. You understand? And here I was hoping for an intelligent conversation for a change. Alas. That's not a problem, though, since this nice young man will surely do it instead. He won't dare be contradictory once we're done with you. Well, nice meeting you and all. Yakov, you may start.
I'll get you even after I'm dead.
That may well happen, Colonel. I could choke on you or something. In the meantime, I'll excuse myself.
Come here! I'll rip you all apart! Every last one of you should have done that before the war! But I'll get you now! Burn to ashes! So not even the darkest pulls!
Now we'll be fooled again! Good.
Artyom! Here. Colonel, sir, I think that's
enough. Thank you, Sam. But it is not. We have to get them. But first, we must find Anna!
I'm sorry, I want you to find the elevator.
To hell with it! Idiot, start the main elevator up!
Ready! Elevator on the move!
Sir, PTA, we can take cover!
Yes, sir!
Well done! We can hold out for that one!
Here, you damn freaks! In the left, motherfuckers!
just like our old D6. Even the lift is the same, exactly.
True, and quite fortunate. This way, we can hope to find Anna. Still, the complex is huge, and we have 10 minutes at the most. So, we'll have to split up. Sam, you check the filter room, the generator hall, and the storage. Idiot, you come with me to the command center. Artyom, you take the barracks and the sick bay. Let's go!
Your floor, Artyom.
Come on, Artyom!
Thank you. It hurts! Me!